The Knight of Shrouds are spectral commanders born of tragedy and betrayal. In this video, we're going to be painting the Knight of Shrouds in two parts. The first part will be focused on getting him battle ready, so this will be base coating him, shading and dry brushing. And the second part, should you wish to take him further, will be focused on extra details such as highlighting. So when you're ready, let's get started. So the first thing we're going to need to do before we begin painting is to undercoat the model. And as you can see here, I've used Corax White Spray. This is a great starting point for this particular colour scheme. Now the first colour we're going to be applying is Hexray Flame. Now I'll be using a medium shade brush for this, but the first thing we'll need to do is give the pot a good shake. Just pop it open like so. And then what I'm going to do is just load up my brush and try and get as much on it as I can. But I'm going to use my palette here just so I don't have it all flooding at the end of the bristles. So just to get a nice point to it as well. And then what we're going to do is start applying it all over the Knight of Shrouds. In fact, on this particular model, I'm going to apply it over everything. And as you paint later on, some of that green can show through as well, give it a nice spectral look. With the Hexray Flame applied and dry, we're going to move on to the next step. And for this, we'll be using Nighthaunt Gloom. We're going to concentrate on the upper parts of the robes. Now for this, we're going to try and keep it in the recesses, but I'll try and get a blend effect by just rubbing it with my finger as well. So I'm keeping my shade brush. I'm just going to apply some to the palette of the Nighthaunt Gloom, like so. And again, just to get a nice point, just twist your brush like so. And then we'll just start applying it to the model. Like I said, I'm keeping it to the upper parts of the robes. Now this bit here, that's the cowl. That'll be painted another colour at a later stage. So we're just keeping it around here. And then for that blend effect I was talking about, I'm just literally going to wipe my finger like so. With the Nighthaunt Gloom now applied and dry, we're going to move on to doing some dry brushing. For this, we'll be using Ulthran Grey and a small dry brush. Now, the idea behind dry brushing is to get a little bit on your brush like so. Just wipe a little bit off there. And then we'll wipe as much off as we can onto the tissue paper. Any tissue paper would do. Now, it will still leave pigment on the bristles. So when we actually get to the model and start highlighting, you'll start to see it get picked out. So I'm going to be running side by side like this just to pick out those raised areas on the robes. Now obviously as the folds change as you get further up the model, you might want to change the angle that you go at like so, just to pick out those raised areas. Keep doing this all the way across all those robes. And in some places at the base of the robe like this, if you put more pressure on your brush, you'll actually get a better highlight as well. With the dry brushing now done, we're going to move on to the skeletal steed. And for this, we'll be using Screaming Skull to layer over all those bone areas. And then we'll shade all over those bone areas using Seraphim Sepia. So I'm using a medium layer brush. I'm just going to get a little bit of Screaming Skull on my palette, a little touch of water. Now, a little bit of neatness is required here. That's mainly around the rib cages. But to be fair, seeing as you've not actually painted all this flesh yet, you can get away with making some splodges. The idea really is just to turn on those rib cages to a nice bone colour. There's some of the deep recesses there as well, and its legs as well, and its face. With the Screaming Skull now dry, we're going to apply Seraphim Sepia to all those bone areas. Now, when I was painting the bone areas, I didn't bother painting the inside of the rib cage because you're not going to see it, but it's your choice if you wish to do this. And be careful when applying any shade, you don't want it to pool too much near the bottom. You want to give it plenty of time to dry as well. With the bone on the skeletal steed now done, we're going to move on to painting the skin of it. Now for this, we'll be using Incubi Darkness thinned down with Lamy Medium. I'll do three parts Lamy Medium to one part Incubi Darkness. I'll be using my medium layer brush. I'll apply the Lamy Medium first, and I'll be using my brush as a guide, so three paintbrushes worth, and then one paintbrush of Incubi Darkness. Now I'm doing it nice and thin, because actually we'll get some of that green glow showing through from the Hexray Flame. So what I'm going to do, get a nice point to my brush like so, and I'll start applying it to the model. Now you can thin it down a bit more if you wish to, or make it a bit neater, but I tend to find three parts is just right. If you feel the need to do a second coat, by all means do that. You want to apply this to all the skin areas. Now around here, it does go into a bit of a flame effect, so you don't want to go all the way down. So where it starts to look a bit flamey, you just want to leave that Hexray Flame. Once the Incubi Darkness and Lamy Medium mix is dry, we're now going to move on to doing some highlighting. We're doing dry brushing here. We'll be starting with Cabalite Green, and we'll finish off with a real light dry brush of Sabrite Green. As we did before with the Ulthran Grey, we're just going to get a little bit on our brush like so, and then what we're going to do is just rub off as much of that as we can. And the idea is just to pick up some of those raised areas on the steed. We can have a look here. So I'm going to concentrate around where the torn flesh is, so I'm just going to gently just pick out some of those raised areas. Some here. Now you have other areas around the model, so do be careful when you are doing this so you don't transfer onto that. If you do, You can always tidy up later. And also where you start getting this magical flame, you can actually just put a bit more pressure on your brush just to help blend that in a bit as well. With the Cabalite Green dry brush done, we're now going to use Sabrite Green, and we're just going to pick out some of the real fine edge highlights here. And again, we're just gently doing this time, so it's almost like tickling those highlights. So you don't want to go too heavy when you're pressing down. With the dry brushing on the steed now done, we're going to move on to painting some other details. And to start with, we'll be using Rhinox Hide, then some Abaddon Black, and then we'll wash over the Rhinox Hide using Norn Oil. So we'll start with the Rhinox Hide. Apply a little bit to my palette like so, and a small touch of water as well, just so it flows a bit easier. I'm using a medium layer brush here as well. And what we're going to be doing with this is we'll be focusing on the cowl, so that'll all be brown. The scabbard, all of the scabbard, but not the hourglass. And the horns as well of the steed. Take your time with this and try and avoid getting it on all the other areas that you've just painted. With the horns, scabbard and robes now base coated, we're going to use a Abaddon Black on the reins, like so. There's two sides for this. And also he's got a little belt as well, just where his scabbard is. So make sure you get that as well. With the Abaddon Black now on, we're now going to apply Norn Oil to all the brown areas. And this is again the horns, the scabbard and the robes. And you want to give this plenty of time to dry. Now that the Norn Oil is dry, we're going to move on to the metallic areas. And for this, we'll be starting with Lead Belcher. We'll then pick out some details using Balthazar Gold. And then we'll finish off by washing both these areas using Agrax Earthshade. So start with that Lead Belcher. I'm just going to get a little bit to my brush like so and apply it to the palette. I'll also add a little touch of water, not too much, just a tip of a paintbrush. Just get a bit of control. Now I'm just going to get it to a nice point and then we'll start applying it. Now the areas you want to concentrate on this figure are the blade itself, his helmet, so anywhere around here on the wings. He's got some chainmail there as well. There's other details scattered around, like the reins on the horses, like the girdle, that's the thing, the girdle. Once the Lead Belcher's dry, we're going to start applying Balthazar Gold. We'll be doing this to the hilt and also to the haft of the weapon and also his scabbard as well. Try and avoid doing the hourglass if you can, but it doesn't matter if you get any paint on it, as we'll paint over that later. Once the Balthazar Gold's dry, we're going to start applying Agrax Earthshade using a medium layer brush. Now just be super careful when doing this, as you don't want to get it on other areas, and you want to leave plenty of time for this to dry as well. With the Agrax Earthshade now dry, we're going to move on to painting the hourglass, and for this we'll be using Thousand Suns Blue as a base coat, and we'll shade over it with Coelia Green Shade. So keeping with my medium layer brush, I'm just going to apply a little bit to my palette like so, add a little touch of water. Again, just to get a nice point and it flows better on the model as well. And there we are, we'll just start applying it. It's just this little bit here. You can leave the bit in the recess like a greeny glow, or you can just paint it straight. I'm going to leave it with a greeny glow. Using a medium layer brush, we're now going to start applying Coelia Green Shade. Now, you want to be careful here, you don't want to get it on any of those metallic details. With the Coelia Green Shade now dry, this model is pretty much ready for battle. All you'll need to do is just base it with some textured paint and you can start playing some games with it. However, if you want to take your model a step further, what we're going to do now is start highlighting some of those details we've been painting. To start with, we're going to do the ethereal robes, and I'll be using Ulthran Grey, and I'll be using my medium artificial brush for this. So I'm just going to get a little bit to my palette like so, and I apply a little bit of water. And at this point, what we're going to start doing is just really neatly start picking out some of those edges on the robes. I know we did some dry brushing before, but this is just a little bit sharper highlighting. You can use the edge of the brush as well, like some of those other areas, like around the rips in the robes. And there we are, you can see I've highlighted the robes now with Ulthran Grey. I also picked out some of the flame details just around the tips as well, just to give it a nicer highlight. So what we're going to do now is we're going to start highlighting up the bone of the skeletal steed. And for this we'll be using Pallid Witch Flesh. So I'm just using my small artificer brush here. I'm just going to get a little bit to the palette, add a little touch of water as well. Again, as before, just roll it so you get a nice point to it. You'll get better control that way. All we need to do is just start picking out all those raised areas like on the hoofs like such. And then you can move up to the head as well, where you've got all the teeth around the eye sockets. Just take your time when doing this. And there we are, with the bone now done, we're going to move on to some other details. And for this, we're going to start by using Gauze Blaster Green. We're going to highlight the steed's flesh with this. After that, we're going to move on to doing some highlights on the robes and also the scabbard. And for this, we'll use Doomball Brown. Keeping with the robes, but also the horns, we're then going to move and use some Baneblade Brown just for some final highlights. After that, I'm going to do a little bit of dry brushing using Saberite Green, and this is just on the base of the robe, just to give it a bit of an ethereal glow. And after that, I'll use some Tusk or Fur on the scabbard, just to give it the last highlight on that. And then finally, any black details, I'm going to use Dawnstone. So starting with that Gauze Blaster Green, I'm just going to get a nice pointy brush, and then for this, I'm using a small artificer brush, like so, just get it to a nice point. This will give you a lot of control when you're doing those highlights on the flesh. So obviously we've done some dry brushing. I'm just going to concentrate around on some of the very fine edges, or like all the tips like there where it's all torn up. Just give it a real nice contrast. You want to do this on all those areas. With the skin on the horse now done, I'm going to start highlighting the robes and the scabbard. And for this, we're using Doomball Brown. Now, as I'll be adding extra highlights to this at a later stage, I am going to make these slightly thicker than I normally would. That will allow you to see the contrast between the two colours later on. With the robe and the scabbard done, we're now going to use Baneblade Brown, and we're going to do a final highlight on the robe. So we're just going to pick out some of the real raised areas, especially around like the arm joints and stuff like that. And also we're going to start highlighting up the horns as well. Now you can start lighter from here and start quite thick. As you get down to the horn, just go a little bit thinner. And even use like the edge of your brush when doing that. With the horns and robes now highlighted, we're going to finish those robes off with a dry brush of Saberite Green. I'm just going to concentrate this at the bottom of the robes. I'm just going to swing backwards and forwards, and what you'll find is the highlights that you've done near the base of it will start to get a bit of a green tint to it. It'll give it a bit of an ethereal glow. Just do this gently and try and avoid other areas like the robes here and like the chainmail. With the robes now done, we're going to finish the scabbard off with a highlight of Tusk Oil Fur. Again, we just want to a fine highlight here, so probably just using the edge of the brush on the scabbard itself. Just take your time not to get on other areas. And finally, we're going to highlight the black areas using Dawnstone. That's mainly the reins, but there's also the belt of the scabbard as well. See, I'm just using the edge of the brush here at the top, also be doing it at the bottom as well. With the black now highlighted, we're going to move on to some finishing details on the metallics. To start with, we're going to make a rusty effect by thinning down Scrag Brown with Lamy Medium. We'll apply this over the silver areas. On the brass areas, we'll use Nylac Oxide, and to tie all those metallics together, we'll highlight them all using Stormhost Silver. So starting with that Scrag Brown mix, I'm just going to apply a couple of dollops of Lamy Medium just on my palette, and then one paintbrush of Scrag Brown. That should be nice and runny enough for a cool rusty effect. I mean, you can go orange if you want to, but I tend to find a warm brown is probably better. All we're going to do now is just start applying it to the silver areas. You can dab it on in little places where you've got like rivets and pits, and then where there's creases and recesses, just start running it in on all those silver details. Don't forget the chainmail as well. And again, once it's dry, you might want to do a second coat, just to add a bit more definition, but the choice is up to you. With the rust done, we're now going to start adding nylac oxide to all the brass details. And again, just run this into the recesses, avoiding it pooling if you can. Using Stormhost Silver and a small layer brush, we're now going to start highlighting all the metallics. That's both the silvers and the brass details. Again, just picking out the edges if you can, going on the chainmail, just trying to get those raised bits of those rings picked out. And of course, the brass details around the scabbard. With the metallics now finished, the model is almost done. There's just a couple of details left to do. Firstly, we'll do the hourglass, and we're just going to be highlighting this up with Aramin Blue and just picking out some real extreme highlights using a little bit of Pallid Witch Flesh. And to finish the model off, we're just going to pick out those flame details around his hooves and tail at the base of the model as well, using Lamenter's Yellow. So starting with that Aramin Blue, I'm just going to get a small layer brush and a little bit to my palette like so. And then all I'm going to do is actually going to stamp the model a bit, if that makes sense, just to give it kind of a grainy sand kind of effect, just like literally just doing little dabs like that. You start to get little dots around the hourglass. It almost looks like there's sand in there. With the Aramin Blue done, we're just going to use a little bit of Pallid Witch Flesh almost to give like a bit of reflection on the actual hourglass. I'm just going to do a little curvy line just at the top there and a little one on the bottom like so. With the hourglass done, we're now going to finish off by using Lamenter's Yellow on the little flamey details. These are around the hooves, just at the bottom here. The idea is we're just changing the tone of that green to give it more of a yellowy hue, to give it more of a balefire colour. When that's dry, what we recommend doing is just basing it in the colour scheme of your army. With the Knight of Shrouds painted and based, he's ready to take to the battlefield and terrify the enemies in the gash. Now, there are a couple of things to remember when painting this model. Firstly, when using shades or any mixes, just take your time and don't let it pool into those recesses. And if it does do that, just get a brush and soak it up. You don't really want to clog up that detail. And secondly, when using dry brushes, just build those layers up gradually. Try not to do it in one go. We hope you've enjoyed this video. We hope you enjoy painting your own Knight of Shrouds, and we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.